Hey guys, I'm Joe, and welcome to another video tutorial for Premiere Pro. Have you ever wondered how to get those zooming and panning shots without the use of an expensive dolly or slider system? Well, today I'm going to take a look at how you would do that using still images and video clips within Adobe Premiere Pro. So let's go ahead and switch over to the computer and Adobe Premiere Pro and take a look at how we do this. So I've switched over to my desktop and I've got Adobe Premiere Pro up and running, and basically I brought in one image, and this is going to be a real quick tutorial, so I'm only going to deal with one image. The other thing that I've done is I went into the sequence settings and made sure that my height and width were set up for HD quality at 1920 and 1080. So now let's go ahead and we'll get started, and I'll drag this into the timeline and we'll make it 16 seconds is probably too long, but so we'll cut that back to right around 9 seconds. And as you can see, I'm zoomed out pretty far on the DJI Spark box. So the first thing that I want to do is I'm going to have it zoom in and kind of center up the drone in the image. So what I want to do is I want to set my scale and position keyframes by clicking the stopwatch icons next to both the position and the scale. And as you can see here in the timeline, there's keyframes that have been added to the timeline. So then if I come over to pretty much the end of the frame, and I want this to basically scale in, we'll say 120, and then I want to set the position, and I want it to just kind of center up the drone. And actually, we'll go to 130. So now if you look at it, it's gone ahead and added keyframes at the end for the second change. And now what it'll do is it'll give us a nice smooth transition as it zooms and pans in on the image. And one of the things that you want to look for when you're doing this is you don't want to increase your scale or your positions too much over a short period of time. So in this case, we went about 30, we incremented it about 30 over 10 seconds. So that's not too bad, but maybe we want it to be less drastic and we'll drop, actually we don't. Yeah. For this end keyframe here, we want it to be 120 instead. So now let's kind of take a quick look at what that looks like. And 120 seems to be a little bit better as far as the nice smooth motion for the zoom. So that's all there is to simulating zoom and pan within Adobe Premiere Pro. If this video was helpful and this is your first time here, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you'd like to stay up to date on our latest uploads, go ahead and hit the bell icon to turn on notifications. Thanks, and we'll see you soon.